Now in this video we will be talking about the shape of s and p orbital. So what is an orbital? So we already know orbital is a space around the nucleus where the probability of finding an electron is maximum. I repeat, orbital is a region of space around the nucleus where the probability of finding electron is maximum. That is वो एरिया न्यूक्लियस के आसपास का जहां पर इलेक्ट्रॉन के पाए जाने की प्रोबेबिलिटी, प्रोबेबिलिटी मींस व्हाट, संभावना, पॉसिबिलिटी, मैक्सिमम हो, ऑर्बिटल कहलाती है. सो एज आई टॉट यू इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोस, एस ऑर्बिटल हैज ओनली हाउ मेनी सबशेल्स, वन सबशेल, लाइक 1s, 2s, 3s, मींस the s orbital is having only one subshell. So if we draw the diagram of 1s, the shape of s orbital is said to be spherical. So this is 1s orbital. If I draw it properly, then we know there are three axes, x, y and z. Then this is actually spherical in shape, like this. Supposingly this is 1s. If somebody tells us to draw 2s, agar hum 2s banayenge to 2s bhi spherical hoga but size mein 1s se bada hoga. Similarly 3s bhi spherical hoga magar size mein bada hoga, so on, right? To jitne bhi s orbitals hai, chahe wo 1s ho, 2s ho, 3s ho, 4s ho, टिल वट एवर यू वॉन्ट, सभी स्फेरिकल शेप के होंगे बट साइज ऑफ स्फीयर विल बी इंक्रीजिंग. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द शेप ऑफ पी ऑर्बिटल. सो एज यू ऑलरेडी नो, पी ऑर्बिटल इज डम्बल शेप्ड. इट इज डम्बल शेप्ड. So one more thing, if we talk about p orbital, I told you there are three subshells in p. They are px, py and pz. Like say suppose, let me take an example of 2p. To hum inhe kya bolenge subshells ko, 2px, 2py or 2pz. Ya hum aisa keh sakte hain ki 2p subshell ke teen orbitals hote hain. And they are designated as 2px, 2py and 2pz. Now if we draw the diagram, then again we will be drawing the three axes as we know, this is x axis, this is y axis and this is z axis. So if we are supposed to draw 2px, so 2px is dumbbell shape as I told, and the dumbbell will be drawn on x axis. So if somebody told you to draw 2px, this is the representation. Now if we have to draw 2py, then again all the three axes, x, z and this is y. So 2py, the dumbbell will be drawn on the y axis. So this is called as, this was your 2px, this is your 2py. Similarly, if we are supposed to draw 2pz, again we'll be drawing the three axes, x, y and z, and now the dumbbell will be drawn on the z axis. So this is called as 2pz. Now similarly, the shapes of 3px, 3py, 3pz will be drawn similarly, only the size of the dumbbell will increase. If I combine all these three diagrams and if I have to draw them all together, then let us see how it can be drawn. That is also very easy. Again, you draw all the three axes. So I have drawn, this is x axis, this is y and this is z. So if I have to draw all the three all together, then this is your px, then I will draw the lobe on y, this is your py, and then I will draw the lobe on pz, that is your z axis, so this is your pz. So this is the combined structure of p orbital, and this is the independent px, py, pz. One more thing I want to add over here, that as I told, the definition of orbital, it is the region of space where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. ये वो जगह होती है जहां पर इलेक्ट्रॉन के पाए जाने की probability, possibility सबसे ज्यादा होती है. और ये हमें कहां से मिले थे ऑर्बिटल्स, हमें जो है जब हमने क्वांटम नंबर्स पढ़े थे, एजिमुथल क्वांटम नंबर दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय एल, वहां से ये ऑर्बिटल्स के बारे में हमें पता चलता है. सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट द शेप ऑफ एस ऑर्बिटल. एस ऑर्बिटल इज स्फेरिकल इन शेप एंड पी ऑर्बिटल इज डंबल शेप्ड. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.